Jacob trouble. We can see that Esau, okay, the devil that rules this world, okay, is starting to come down even more with his infrastructure, man.
Right.
Okay, they're starting to do what? They're starting to cut off a lot of health benefits. They're starting to cut off what? Unemployment. They're starting to cut off a lot of people from their jobs, taking a lot of things away from them. And it's the time now where brothers really have to activate and believe on that faith.
Hashem, Yahushai, Hashem, Rakhav Kadash. We're here today, you know, to see what we do on Israel. Just to learn about the sins and
go on to the apostle.
Like, yeah. Double honor to the apostle, the letter of GMS, and to all the other fellowships who are pushing this truth. You know, my name is Margot Gabar.
This is Rav Shapat.
Man, we're here today to warn Israel and continue warning them over and over about the sins. Things how to change the way and to live up unto the law and to follow the Lord's statutes and commandments. Man, I want to start off with the book of
it's called Sanctify This
Place. Start off with the book of at second address, chapter 16, verse 75. Be not afraid, ye that doubt, for God is the guide, right?
76.
Yeah, it's like here. Look at second address, chapter 16, verse 76. And the guide of them who keep my commandments and precept said the Lord God, let not your sins weigh you down.
Yeah, that's right, because as a nation of Israel, you blacks, Latinos, Native Americans, right? You know, we face the conditions that we face in today's society. Why? Because we failed to follow the law, statutes, and commandments of Yahweh HaShem.
Right.
So for the brothers that get in this truth, from time to time you may go off, from time to time you may fall, right? But the scriptures is telling you, don't let your sins weigh you out. Right?
Go ahead. Continuing on. Let not your sins weigh you down, and let not your iniquities lift up themselves.
Yeah. Don't let your iniquities lift up themselves. You live in these bodies, these weak bodies. And sometimes right. Your mindset is, oh, I'm annoyed. Oh, I'm lacking this, and I'm lacking that. Or I broke the laws, statutes, and commandments. You know? You're going to fall daily, all right? Hey, the scriptures say, our righteousness is as filthy rags. So it's not to get high-minded when you're keeping the law, because that's not you keeping the law.
Right.
Any righteousness that comes from these vessels is being done through the spirit and power of Yahweh HaShem. You don't get no more credit. You don't get credit at all, actually. We dropped the ball long ago. We've been dropping the ball, right? We went off. Our forefathers sinned. We sinned.
Right.
So this is why we're put in these conditions, in these hellish conditions now.
Right.
But when you're in this walk, you don't let your sins weigh you down. You don't let your iniquities lift up themselves against you.
Right? Right.
You went off, now repent. Right. Listen to the counsel that's being said to you, because of Yahweh HaShem Yahshua.
Yep.
And
right.
Put it into play. Don't be given lip service. You understand? This walk of life is a walk of doing, a walk of action. That's why it says they shall rehearse the righteous acts. Go ahead, you have more than that?
Yeah. 37. Second address, chapter 16 to 77.
Mm-hmm.
Woe unto them that are bound with their sins.
Yeah, destruction unto those that are bound with their sins. Who is that?
Two-thirds of our people, you blacks, Latinos, Native Americans, that are bound in your sin. And how are you bound in your sins? Because what is the only way to free you from sin? Right?
Right.
What is the only way to free you from sin?
It's only through Yahweh HaShem.
Right. Free yourself is repenting and coming back to the Most High, Yahweh HaShem Yahshua. That's the only way to free your sins and to save your soul. You know? If you don't go that route, but then you're on the left hand side. Continuing. Book of 2nd Address 16, verse 77. Woe unto them that are bound with their sins and cover.
Hold on, slack. Let me read this real quick. Romans 2 and Romans 9, Romans 8 and 8. Romans 8, verse 1. There is therefore no condemnation to them which are in the Mashiach Yahusha, who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. Meaning what? We're not bound to our sins anymore, because they're not walking after the flesh. The flesh is, I did this, I did that. I keep the Sabbath. I keep the high holy days. I rock fringes. I keep my fringes on all day. All right? I don't commit adultery. I don't lie. I don't steal. That's I. No. Once you break one law, you're guilty of breaking them all.
Right.
So now, if you're in the spirit of Yahweh HaShem Yahshua, who kept the law, right? Perfectly. That spirit is the one that gets recognition, right? Because you walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. Verse 2, for the law of the spirit of life in the Mashiach Yahusha have made me free from the law of sin and death.
Right.
Read that again. What is that? Woe what?
It's book of second address, chapter 16, verse 77. Woe unto them that are bound with their sin and covered with their iniquities. Like as a field is covered over with bushes.
Yes, and that's what our people are going through.
Right.
Right? Two-thirds of our people that have not repented, they're bound with their sins, and they're covered with their iniquities. And the only way to be free from that is you have to worship Yahweh HaShem Yahusha. Yes, you should be worshiped. You gotta repent. You gotta get that forgiveness. Right? Finish it real quick. Back at Romans 8 and 3. Now it says, for what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh. Why wasn't the law not able to make us free? Because it was weak through the flesh.
Right.
Meaning what? The flesh was not able to keep the law. We broke it.
Right.
We went off. We served idols. We served a Baal. We went into the different temples. Different deities and idols. Right? That's what happened. No, you guys go through. You guys go through. That's what happened, right? So whatever the law could not do, right? It was made weak through the flesh, right? Meaning our fleshy bodies was made to keep it.
Right.
Right? Let me finish. It says, it was made weak through the flesh. The Most High sending his own son in the likeness of sinful flesh, all right? In the likeness of sinful flesh, he was in the same body, had to go face the same temptations, had to go through the same tribulations, all right? And for sin, condemned sin in the flesh. How did he condemn sin? By not breaking the law and keeping the law, right?
Right.
When he was in the body, that body of Yahushua, right? It says, verse 4, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us. How is the righteousness in the law fulfilled in us? It's not through your actions. You brothers right. Gotta get off that high horse that you think you're the ones keeping the law. No, you gotta be grateful. When you see the fringes on you, it reminds you of the laws. Yes, it does. But also it should remind you that you didn't keep the laws and that we have to keep the laws through us.
Right.
Right? It says that the law of righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. Okay? So you walk after the spirit. The spirit is what? Word. The word is who? Yahushua,
right?
Yahushua is in brothers, right? Brotherly advice, keep it. Brotherly unity, keep it, right? Build it, raising the 12 tribes of Israel, preaching this word, all right? That is your calling, man. That's what we're meant to do.
Right.
You got more on that second address?
You have to give away where you
can go. Second address? Second address, chop that thick. Luke 77. Woe unto them that are bald and thin, covered with their iniquities, like as a field is covered with bushes, and the part thereof covered with thorns, that not man may travail, that no man may travail true, may travel true. Luke 78. It is left undressed and is cast into the fire to be consumed therewith. Once you don't cleanse your sins and you don't change your ways, you'll be cast in the fire. Pretty much the Most High is saying here, you know. You have to change your ways, you know. You gotta repent and come back to the Most High because you'll be cast in this and you will die. One road, you'll be left one side. Once on the left hand side, you're released to death, you know? So you have to build up a loin, you know, and try to show you put the gospel of hope, like the scripture says, you know? So this is what you have to do. Mm-hmm. If you do not, you can end up on the left hand side and you're bound for death, you know? Because you're your destiny is death, you know what I'm saying? So, you made your destination.
Melted. I mean, it's not melted, but it's frozen. And these dudes think they could come step on it. One dude almost fell in it. The ignorance of our people. Or the ignorance of the nations in general. We don't know who they could be.
Yeah, this is the book of Psalm. Chapter 55, verse 22. Look it out. Cast thy burden upon the Lord, and he shall sustain thee. Anyway, this is the Lord saying, you know, you're not supposed to be holding all this dead weight of sin, and you're going to cast the burden upon the Lord. You know, if you cast the burden upon the Lord, you know, he's waiting, you're going to sustain you. Sustain means to uphold you up, you know, sustain, you know. He will uphold you up and he will protect you, you know. He shall never suffer the righteous to be moved. Yeah, well, you know, your foot never move, you know. Your foot will move, you know, you'll be showing the gospel of hope, you know.
So, you know, they're saying cops are going to fund the mall, you know? You know, and stuff, we don't want to understand it.
Gotta cast your burden on the Lord, because in today's society, today, you know, the men of our nation, we're looked at as nothing, right? Who's the one that set up the, you know, the garden? You know, who's the one that put servants out there to paint the streets and put street signs up there? Right? It's our enemies, right? We're in this captivity. So the women of our nation, they don't respect us. You know, the children don't respect us, right? They're not going to give us that respect because they see it as if we're not running nothing. We're not running anything. But really, we're building up the house of the Halbashim Yal Shah, which is what the foundation being set up. The foundations of old. Same thing our forefathers did, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Right?
Right.
Psalms 37 and 32.
Book of Psalm 37. Psalm 37 and 32.
Psalm 37 and 32.
Psalm 37 and 32. The wicked watcheth the righteous and seeketh to slay him. Yeah, well, definitely right. Definitely wicked too, you know. The wicked will watch your righteous, you know. So when you think somebody watching the wicked, you know, the wicked always watching you because, like, you keep just saying Job, you know, the devil will up and down at 240 yards, so you will not be watching, you know, but the devil watching at all times, you know. So the wicked eyes on you, you know.
How are some ways that they watch you and seek to slay you, right?
Yep.
They put out these mandates,
yep.
All right? They put out these bad conditions in the neighborhood, right? They put out the bad food, the bad school system, right? You know how easy it is to make crime go up, right? You know, remove the strong, power figure male out the household, right? Replace an effeminate woman, all right? That makes the male more emotional. The crime rate goes up, which brings the property values down because there's so much crime in the neighborhood. No businesses want to get open up there. No good schools with high class professors want to work in those areas. So what are you getting? The bottom of the bottom.
Right.
And he watches the slave food, his music videos.
Right.
Consistently promoting violence, consistently promoting homosexuality, consistently promoting lies through the tell-lie vision. Okay? And he's sneaking to slay the righteous, man. He's looking to slay the elect. Right? He's putting, if you just gotta watch this society looking down as a man looking on the map, what Esau thinks he can do, you know, so for white man, is put, you know, scenarios in place that Jake is gonna conform to and become a sponge to. It's just like the Matrix. No, but he really seeking to destroy the righteous.
Right.
Wants you to go up, wants you to denounce the name of Yahweh, Bashim, Yahusha, all right? Wants you to sell out, teach the false doctrine, right? Sow discourse among brethren, break up the unity. That's what he really want to do,
right?
You got something? Let me get real quick. Give me 2nd Ezra 16 and 53. Let me get Luke 22. Is Luke 22? Psalm 16 and 53.
Second
entrance. 16 and 53. I'm getting Luke 21 and 31. So I get Luke 22. 22 and 31. I'm gonna start at
This is Luke 22 and 31. And the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan hath desired to have you, that he may sift you as wheat. Hey, why is that? He want to get you shaking out the truth.
Right.
He's designed to have every one of the elect and the one-third. You want to bring chaotic situations around you. You want to bring tribulations around you. He want to throw in your face how much you have sinned against the Lord. All right? Oh, the Lord not dealing with you. Now the ones that sold them into slavery. Now the ones that put them down crucified. All right? And that's the thing he want to push up on our people. He want to sift you as wheat. Real quick, hold on. Give me Romans, give me Amos 9 and 9. And this is why you can't sit there on a down scene, all right? You missed a shot. Keep going. Get up with your soldier, all right? And you go 10 times harder, right? Rise up, fall 7 times, you get back up 7 times. There's no time in this battle to be mourning and dwelling on the iniquities of your sins. Amos 9 and 9. For lo, I will command and I will sift the house of Israel among all nations like a corn is sift in a sieve, yet shall not the least grain fall upon the earth.
Yeah, and what is the least grain that won't fall upon the earth? Right? The
Most High's elect is one third.
Right.
As you're being sifted, the Lord is going to make sure that the elect, one third, get delivered, get preserved. Is this not a truth that you should not want to be a part of? What's wrong with the Most High, the Creator, choosing us as being the perfect and as being the righteous and as being the most favorable in His eyes? But our people are against that because they are more in the servitude mentality.
Right.
Why? Because they have been comfortable. They have been pacified. Yep. They have been pampered. When you grow up your whole life from generation to generation and being told lies, and then when you walk amongst society, all you see is your other nations operating things that are important to you in your life. What are you going to do? You look at them as God.
Right.
That's why the so-called black woman, Eve, she don't respect us. You know, even if she's doing it consciously or subconsciously in her mind, when she says, I don't need a man, how could you not need your man of your nation?
Right.
It does not make sense. The Lord said, it's not good for man to be alone. We'll make him a helpmate.
Right.
All right? And this is why you were made for. So how do you not need a man if you was made for him? You do need a man, because that's what makes you complete as a woman, because she was taken from what? Man.
Right.
So when a woman says, I don't need a man, I got my job on my own, right? I got my degree on my own, I pay my own bills, I buy my own clothes, I got my own designer clothes, I got the S550, the BMs, right? I got the six-figure job, I got boss titles, all right? I'm bosses, I'm executive, I'm selling Tampa Bay, I'm the top real estate agent, female. So when they come in that mindset, what they're not understanding is who set up these opportunities for you. It still was who? A man.
Right.
Yeah. Who's running it right now? Esau, our nation, our enemy, the wicked nation, Esau, but it's still a man that gave you the opportunity to what?
Right.
Serve, buy clothes, buy that Billy, get that money. Whose face is name is on the money? Whose face is on it? A man, right? Regardless. Now, is that the man you need? No, you need the man of your nation, but we're in captivity.
Yeah.
But all the things that you're glorifying in is temporary. It should soon be over.
Yeah.
And who's going to run the kingdom now?
Man.
Right. Who sits on the 12, is going to sit on the 12 the 12 thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel? Man.
Right.
You're going to always need the man.
Right.
Right? So regardless, everything that you're glorifying and say you don't need a man is you're still getting it from who?
A man.
Right?
That's a false sense of security. That is exactly what you have, a false sense of security, You're thinking that all these material things could protect you, Like you cut it from the off.
Yeah.
You wanna pick the ball through, you wanna get the best job and you wanna get the career and the job and then get a man. So you could be a boss lady
you was at help, you won't be a boss lady. So you already just tripped the man in right, so. Mm-hmm. So you two boss in a house, you don't work like that, you know?
Exactly.
But wait until when they have Jacob come around and
yeah.
And them maniac ran the house and break up the TV and sling you over the, you know, then they go cry for a man. You know, then they will cry for that man because the BMW car protecting and all these things they have is a force of security. You know, so you're not covered. You know, you don't want the man around.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Yeah. Alright. I'll let you right.
I'll
do nothing.
Yeah, keep on.
Now, this is Amos chapter 9, verse 10. All the sinners of my people shall die.
Wow.
By the sword.
Wow, he did it again.
Right. This is Amos chapter 9, verse 10. All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword. Yeah. Yeah, and who the sword? And they will die by the who the sword? You know, the sword is the sword, you know? That is sword, you know? And they were going to die by, you know? He has the sword, you know?
So you're telling me that the Most High kills? The Most High is now all loving and...
Yeah.
The Most High kills.
Yeah.
Right? The Most High is gonna kill sinners.
Yeah, but all these sinners, all the ones who transgress gonna die by the sword. You're gonna die, you know, you're not gonna live, you know. So if you feel that you protected and you have your house and you know you have your house paid for and you're good to go and you have money in the bank and extra job, yeah. If you think all these things are protect you, no, you will die because you're transgressing, you're sinning, you. And it will die by the sword. You know, this country took up here to die. You're not gonna live. You're not gonna survive here. This place is death, and everything here leading up is to death. Everything you're doing here, once on the right hand side, once you know you have Hashem Yahusha, and on the left hand side, lead up to death. This is what the scripture is saying here.
Let me read this real quick. This is Psalms 49 and 6. I'm going to read verse 4. It says, I will incline my ear to a parable. I will open my dark saying upon the harp. That's what we incline our ear to a parable, right? Right?
Right.
We incline our ear to the parable of the Lord, right? Verse 5. Wherefore should I fear in the days of evil, which the iniquity of my heel shall compass me about? Question, right? Verse 6, like the priest was just mentioning about you feeling like you're established and you're all set up, right? Verse 6, they that trust in their wealth and boast themselves of the multitude of their riches, none of them can by any means redeem his brother, right, nor give the Most High ransom for him.
Right.
Like, you're not going to be able to redeem your brother like that. Mm-hmm. We're not out here boasting upon riches, boasting upon your pension, boasting upon how much money you got in the bank. You can't redeem your brother like that. You women can't save your own damn children like that.
That's right.
Right? The only way to is to repent and find Yahushua, Yahusha.
Right.
It says, verse 9, that he should still live forever and not see corruption. No, slack it. Verse 8, for the redemption of their soul is precious. It ceases forever, that he should live forever and not see corruption. And that's the goal that we're seeking for.
Right.
You guys have false goals and false hopes. Verse 10, for he seeth, it says, verse 10, for he seeth the wise man die, likewise the fool and the British person, brutish person perish and leave their wealth to others. You know, when you go to that cemetery, funeral home, what they're going to do is, let me look up how much money and expenses he has.
Yep.
So we can, you're entitled to that too. You leave your wealth for others. Now you're in the spirit world. You're not caring about what's down here.
Right.
That is not the goal that you should be seeking, right? Verse 12. Yeah, that's about it. That was it. You could finish
it. Yeah, I'm gonna finish it. Amos chapter 9, verse 10. All sinners of my people shall die by the sword, which say, the evil shall not overtake nor prevent us.
And that's their mindset.
Right.
Oh, when is he gonna come?
Yeah.
We all gonna die anyway. We gotta die.
Yeah. One life to live.
Ain't no evil coming to us.
Yeah.
Take them, Vanessa.
Yeah.
You've been eating bad food all your life. Take the Vanessa. You done had sex with different chicks without a condom. Take the Vanessa.
Yeah.
You eat GMO food. No evil's gonna happen to you.
Yeah.
Take the RFID microchip. What is the chip gonna do to you?
Yeah.
It's about protecting your family.
That's their mindset, thinking evil is not gonna come to them.
Yeah, I'll come to them.
You know?
Yeah.
That's the man.
That was it?
I know. What was that second address? You remember it? 16 and 53?
Yeah. Second address, 16 and 53. Let not the sinner say in thy Salakia.
Yeah, 53 is lucky.
This is our second address, 16:53. Let not the sinner say that he had not sinned. For Yahweh Bashem Yahushua shall burn coals of fire upon his head.
That's right. Thinking that the evil is not going to come upon you.
I ain't sin. What sin?
No. Hey, we are in sin, man. Sin is what? Transgression of the law.
Right.
All right? You sin, and the Lord is going to burn those coals upon your head. Go ahead.
Right. Which saith before the Lord, Yahweh, and his glory, I have not sinned. See, so this one, Israel keeps saying to themselves, they always, I ain't sinning. They always say this thing about themselves, you know. You don't want to understand again. You know, but this scripture says, hold them upon them. Behold, the Lord knoweth all the works of men. Yeah, the Lord knows all works of men, you know, the Lord knows everything, you know, he sees everything, you know, he makes the world, like, you know, like the scripture says, you can check all the hair on your head. You know, the Lord sees everything. I don't know why people believe that they're not being seen, or they can hide in a dark place, you know, woe to that person, you know.
Hey, we just came from Dwayne Reed, and I was looking, and I don't know if that's what she did,
the lady that was purchasing from the self-buying machine, but what came to my mind was, just wicked jakes out there in general. They got 4 or 5 items, but then they'll beat their skin about 2 of them and pay for 2 and put the rest of the items in their bag. And I was like, man, it's not enough staff to watch her, or, you know, watch an individual that does that. But then in my mind, the spirit hit me. It was like, yeah, but the Most High sees her. The Most High sees her, and she's going to get charged for that iniquity. You know what I'm saying? The Lord is gonna want his payment for those sins.
Right.
And that payment is death.
That's right.
But who made that payment? What insurance are you under? All right. The policy of Yahweh Bashem Yahusha, man.
That's right.
Man.
This is Second Address 16:54. Behold, the Lord knoweth all the works of men, their imagination, their thoughts, and their hearts.
Yep.
Yeah, but the Lord knows everything. You know your imagination. Before you even think it, the Lord knows it, So, he allow it to do that to see where you're going. It's like a road to walk. Like a fork in the road, You know, he watching to see what you're doing. You know, it's your choice to choose.
Exactly.
You know, it's your choice to choose, and he watching to see what you're doing. So, he see your imagination. Before you even think to shoot the man, he know you're going to shoot the man. But what will you say? I can't do that for dying. No right to do that. If I shoot this man, I can't kill the next man. I can't do that. But no, you were doing that. You're going forward. Nothing is stopping you. You don't have that right. You need to stop your own self. You know, you can't, if you want to rob somebody, who's stopping you? You're continuing to sin because you're keeping on that unrighteous spot.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, imagine you're leading yourself to your own death.
Mm-hmm.
You're walking to your own death.
Mm-hmm.
You know? You escape, you shoot the man, and you run, and you run away. You change your license plate, and you change your thing, and then they rent a car, and they're gonna kill this guy, right? And they reach home safe. You think you safe because the police didn't catch you that day? Or you can change your plate, but they're tracking you.
Yeah, exactly.
Yo, you still a dead man walking, yo.
Exactly, because you need that payment.
Yeah.
You need to be redeemed. Yeah. What you did.
Yeah.
Justice shall be served.
Yeah.
All this, oh, justice wasn't done. My little boy was shot. No, yes, best believe that the Most High is going to bring justice to all those that was murdered, that was lied to, that was stolen from, that was robbed, that was defrauded.
Right.
The Most High is going to bring justice to those that are in sin, man.
Right. Because
in everything. In everything. In the midst of everything. He said that all the sinners of my people shall die by the sword. All
right.
Right? Give me Isaiah 42 and 16. Lock here. You know what? Hold on. Give me Sirach 12 and 6. Yes, because the Most High don't like people with that type of mindset, thinking that justice shall not be served. Yeah. And, you know, breaking the law is easy. You know, hey, we know we ain't gonna keep all the laws. That's for the men of the Lord that have repented already.
Right.
That have that covering.
Right.
For you dudes out there that do not know Yahweh Shah, that have not been delivered, that have not repented, have not seek that forgiveness, you're done. You're doomed.
Right.
Yes, the law applies to you 100%.
Right.
And it's gonna destroy you for not following.
Right.
But only those that are not under the law are in the law of Yahweh Shah now.
Right.
Right? Those are the ones that's covered. Those are the ones that, you know, they fall, you know, because of the bad habits of the flesh.
Yep.
They can redeem themselves and get back up, keep serving Yahweh Shah, and praying and hope. But you dudes that forsake Yahweh Shah totally, you're done. You're doomed. He doesn't look at sin. Sin is just in the Old Testament. It's nothing. The Most High hates sinners.
The Most High hates sinners. Strong word. Hate.
Who does the Lord look at as sinners? Those are not covered in Yahweh Shah. Not Jesus. Not Yeshua. Right? Not Jehovah. In Yahweh Shah.
Right.
That's who the Most High doesn't deem as sinners.
Right.
Other than that, the Most High hate you niggas, man.
Yeah.
You niggas, you spits. All you that work iniquity and wickedness, the Most High hates you.
Yeah.
Right? And that's out of the Bible, man. That's not our words. We're preaching it. We're delivering it. We're the messengers of the Lord.
That's right.
The angels of the Lord. Yeah.
That's right.
It's, 2nd address 16. 2nd address, Sirach 12 and 6. For the Most High hate his sinners. I will repay vengeance. I will repay vengeance unto the ungodly.
And will repay vengeance unto the ungodly.
Right. So the Lord will redeem and bring justice. Your little cousin, Nene, that got shot on the corner.
Right.
Hey, who just got shot up? Nas Blinky with me, wicked as all hell anyway.
Right.
But what I'm saying is the innocent bystanders, you know, which we are all not innocent. You know,
right.
We all broke the law, statutes, and commandments.
Right.
But yes, the Lord will bring vengeance. He will pay the vengeance for sinners for what they have done against him.
Right.
So we all ought to repent, you know, mourn, and ask the Lord for forgiveness. Right?
Yeah.
And keep them against the mighty day of their punishment.
That's right.
Like you were saying through the Holy Spirit.
Right.
They're walking around, cops didn't catch them.
Yeah.
They change their license plate, they change their location, go hide in a foreign country.
Yeah.
No, the Lord's still gonna repay you for the day of punishment.
Right.
And even when you die,
the
Lord will send your spirit back into that grave, into that body. You will rise up out of the dirt, just like the elect. It's going to rise up. Them that die in the Lord is going to rise up first and go into those chariots. Those that die in iniquity, you're going to rise up to be condemned for that judgment.
Right.
It's nuclear fire. You see what's going on in Russia.
Right.
You see what's going on in the Ukraine border. Right. You see America putting their foot in there because they don't know how to mind their damn business. So come on, we're allies with everyone.
You see what's going on. We are at the end.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Yeah, bring it up. I got something.
This Ecclesiastic 8 and 11. Because sentence against an evil work
How?
Is not exalted speedily.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore the heart
Yeah.
This book of
executed.
Yeah. The book of Ecclesiastic was Ecclesiastic chapter 8 verse 11. Because sentence against an evil work is not executed speedily.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore the heart of the Son of Man is fully set in them to do evil.
Break it down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well exactly. Well, you never escape, so you thinking that you know that you escape by doing a crime, you know, you never escape, you know? Because your heart is set with evil. You know, and if the Lord says not speedily, you're not gonna you getting caught up thinking that, oh, the Lord not here because I kill this guy today and I ain't die tomorrow. No, it don't work like that. You ain't gonna die tomorrow. It might happen to you next week or next month. But your judgment coming, yo. It coming, so it's not speedily. The scripture says not speedily. So you leave it. You might kill again. You might kill two more people. You might rob two more people. But adding up, it's like a credit card billing, yo. And when the time comes, your goal's gone, yo. The Lord take you out, yo. Take you out. Because it's not speedily. Verse 12. Though a sinner do evil 100 times and his days be prolonged, yet surely I know that it shall be well with them that fear God and fear God which fear before him. Yeah, well, you could go ahead and, you know, I mean, you could go and kill 1,000 times and you'll never get away. You know? This is scripture saying.
No, keep going.
You know what I'm saying? But, you know, but the people who fear the Lord, they can sit right with them, you know? The people who fear the Lord will know that, hey, you know what? We need to leave this. Let's leave alone.
That's right.
You know? We've seen, we know. Mm-hmm. So we know that we fear the Lord, so we know that, but you have feared the Lord.
Exactly.
So you think you could do it 100 times. Because there's spirit on here, you know, you feel like a robot 1,000 times because the spirit of that demon will say, alright, kill what I never kill again. He want more. You feel that spirit, that demon on you will need to kill or to rob or to thief car. Yeah. You know, like you can thief one car and say, Lord, okay, I thief one car, repent, and that is it. But no, you want to thief four cars.
Exactly.
Yeah, because that spirit will drive you. That spirit will keep on you. Yeah. The only way that spirit will for you is if you repent and your bashman shall take over this shit.
Exactly. That's the key thing. Yeah. Yahweh Hashem Yashah got to drive the vessel.
Yeah, you got to drive the vessel. Yo.
Flesh is weak, but the spirit is willing.
Huh?
You got more on Shabbat?
That's 12?
Shabbat 12.
Oh, Shabbat 12. Book of Rock. Sirach
11.
Book of Sirach chapter 12, verse 6. For the Most High hated sinners, I repay vengeance unto the ungodly, and keepeth them against the mighty day of their punishment. And 7. Give unto.
Let me get this real quick. Isaiah 42:6, right? Because this is what we're looking forward to, right? Isaiah 42:6. It says, The Lord have called thee in righteousness, and will hold thy hand, and will keep thee, and give thee for a covenant of the people, for a light of the Gentiles. That's the calling that that Yahweh Hashem Yashah has brought brothers into. So right. We have a calling, and we have a job to do. Right? We got to be a light unto the Gentiles.
Right.
Wealth, money, and riches, that can't redeem your brother.
Right?
But the light, the truth, shall do it. Right?
Mm-hmm.
It says, verse 2, to open the blind eyes, to bring out the prisoners from prison, that spiritual blockage, right? That dull mindset, that delusion, that walking in the algorithm of Esau in society, right? The Lord said he's gonna bring us to be a light to those Gentiles, right? Those that are in a foreign state of mind to rule the nations,
right?
That says, verse 7, to open the blind eyes, to bring out the prisoners from prison,
and them that sit in darkness out of the prison house.
Right?
For I am the Lord, that is my name, Yahweh Shalom Shah, Hashem Kodesh. It says, and my glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images. Right? So the Lord doesn't give his glory to another, and he's not in his praise to graven images. Okay? I'm going to jump down to verse 16. Isaiah 42 and 16. It says, and I will bring the blind by the way that they knew not. I will lead them in the paths that they have not known. I will make darkness light before them and crooked things straight. These things will I do unto them that forsake that unto them and not forsake them.
Right.
So who said they was going to do this and put us in righteousness, walk us in the path, build these camps up, have us doing the high holy days, having us do brotherly love, having us watch over brothers, you know, and build them up, right? Who said that? It was Yahweh Shalom, the Most High, right? And how did he start that? Who did he send? You know, let me get real quick. You got something? You got something? Bring it out. You got it. Yeah, bring it out. Then let me get my
This is Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 16. This is Yahweh Shalom speaking Jeremiah 4. Jeremiah here. I feel like I have 17. No, therefore, load up your loins and arise and speak unto them all that I commanded thee.
That's right.
All that commanded thee. All commanded us. We gotta speak unto
whether they hear or forbid.
We're not here about emotional feelings.
Right.
Because the majority of our people, they're not gonna listen. They're gonna remain in their hearted mind.
Right.
They're gonna stay in their wickedness. Why? Because they love it. They love the gun. They love the slums.
Right.
You know, they love being servants and slaves.
Right.
Right? But we still gonna speak to them and tell them the way of righteousness, because out of 100 of those gang members and those strippers and those, you know, crackheads and those worshiping idols, you're going to find one brother that the Most High is going to raise up out of them.
Right.
That's why we got to preach the word.
Right.
Be not dismayed at their faces, lest I confounded thee before them. Mm-hmm. 18. For behold, I have made this, this day a defensive city, and an iron pillar, and bracing wall against the whole land, against the kings of Judah, and against the princes thereof, and the priests thereof, and against the people of the land. The Lord, we're speaking for the Lord, and not to be the voice of the Lord. That we have to redo, you know? Mm-hmm. The way that we had to warn the people, you know?
Mm-hmm.
We had to go up the loins and warn the people and be not dismayed by their faces, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So we can't get, we'll be in fear, you know, because they have no love in them. We had to tell them, the things, you know? We had to cry out and tell them, you know?
Exactly.
So we had to tell them how it is, you know? Mm-hmm. We can't put what they want to talk to Israel,
right.
You know? Because they want to hear smooth things, you know? We had to tell them the truth, you know? Die sin, don't do that. You can't do this, you can't do that. This thing you have to tell you, yo. You have to tell you that thing, you can't commit adultery, homosexuality, you can't do all these things, yo.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so this is what we have to do, to warn the people.
Exactly. Malachi 4:5, because
the Most High is restoring us, and when they can do that, when they start, books were open. The Father is finished. Right? The knowledge were open. The books were open. The seals thereof was unsealed. Right? The knowledge was released from the heavens.
Right.
And who brought forth that truth?
Malachi 4:5.
Book of Malachi chapter 4:5. Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet.
Exactly.
Before the coming of the great and wonderful day of the Lord.
And what's the great wonderful day of the Lord? What is that day?
That's the day of judgment. That's the day when Yahweh shall return.
Right.
Alright? In his full potential and his glory. Before that, the Lord had a prophecy and said he was going to send us Elijah the prophet. So when the Lord said in Isaiah 42 and 16, I will
I will bring the blind by the way that they knew not. I will lead them in the paths that they have not known. I will make darkness light before them and crooked things straight. These things will I do unto them and not forsake them.
When you read Malachi 4, he sent us Elijah.
Right.
Right? Which was John the Baptist. Okay?
And when did he come? When did he come?
Right? When did he come? Did he not come in a vessel, you know, abominations?
Right.
Right? Around the 1900s. Hey, even vocab is astonished by it. He, at one time you watch his videos, he's scoffing, you know, but more he's amazed and astonished at his truth. And he just, the breakdowns that it's still to this day, you know, that's been there since the 1900s, since World War I.
That's the color.
Yeah, identical. Since you, before you was even born. So his mindset is like, wow, I can't, how can I go against something that was here before me? You over here trying to disannul or debunk something that flourished and endured. One thing about a lie, it has an ending. Right. At one point it's exposed. At one point it switches course. At one point it changes its lie. The truth endures forever. It remains the same.
For a kind of light.
It remains the same, that straight path.
Right.
It never changes. Yep. And that's one thing about the truth. And you see that through our priests, Abba Bivens, Ariyah, King Marshall, Pastor Tahar, Pastor Babar, Pastor Aramla, Pastor Rakar, all right? You see that, Elder Manatazah, you see that.
Right.
You see the truth remaining the same. And we are, like he brought out, that defense city that's continually pushing the truth to what?
Right.
Raise up our people, to get them out of that violent mindset,
right,
that ignorant mindset. Hey, one thing our nation thought was good for our people to deal with mental disorder was what? Lobotomy. So you have one instance in the 1900s, they're sticking a damn tube ice pick in your forehead, telling you this is how you got to sever the brain to get rid of some mental disorders. When all you had to do was read the scriptures, build the unity, all right? It says you love your brother as thyself. You love yourself, you're not going to rob yourself, so why should you rob your brother? Why should you sleep with another man's wife? Why should you not push forth the righteousness, raise up the kids in the right manner? No, but you live in a wicked society where who bringing the drugs?
Right.
Who bringing the guns? Right. Who's opening now in Harlem a damn heroin clinic, saying that drug addicts could come there and smoke heroin?
For free, come out and smoke, and they want to get you there.
It's because they want to destroy the people
that
to the point it poured on their people now. Now they lost control of the wickedness.
Yeah.
Right, but reading out about Abba Bivens, all right, which is Elijah,
right,
that's who came forth before the great and dreadful day, man, and that's
right.
Beautiful, man. All praises to Yahweh, Shabbat Shalom,
Shabbat
Shalom, for that, man.
Right.
There's more than
that? Yeah, like I said, I mean, when he came back, Abba Bivens came back, and he light that spirit on fire, you know, spark the flame back, you know, spark up that flame to make the opportunity for me and the teacher had to bring his board out. He came back and he sparked it, yo.
Right.
He don't feel that, you know, he tried to stop the elect and to stop the truth by slavery, like more that this. But at the end of the day, he cast up this truth, you know? Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah, Yahweh Bibrin, that now spark that flame. And great men, you know, great men come through that flame and that light. And now we're here today to
till this day.
That light, yo.
This day, my Andrew vocab, you be scoffing, coming at brothers, running down on every camp. Hey, even if you are a spy, which we believe you're an agent, you are amazed. And if you are an Israelite or a Jake, you know, you better chill because you're going to get converted. You're going to believe in this truth, man. You're going to believe in this truth. You're going to see the power of Yahweh Shinao Shah.
Right.
You know, dude was a man. Hey, Apostle Charles, would be an elderly. High priest, all right, you think you come and go head to head with the apostle, right?
Right.
So now when you see the foundation, you're like, oh wow, this same breakdown.
Same thing, you know.
This, wow, what the? You amazed by it. And if you want to take it and put it in a museum, the Book of Abba Bivens is the foundation of one Westerns.
the Hebrew Israelites.
Yep.
Hey man, it's beautiful, man. Y'all about to see y'all shall move, man, because you can't go against this word. You just can't. You can't go against it, man.
Right, you can't. You know, they like to show you in the movie Matrix, Agent Smith, where he was able to just hop in people's bodies, man. That's a twofold scenario, because that's the same way how the truth was. People was walking around thinking they was in their daily life.
That's
Spirit of the Lord. Do my will, my work. You know what I'm saying? Push the word. Forsake everything. This world is a delusional. It shall be destroyed.
Yep.
And what you gonna do? Follow the spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahshua.
Yep.
You know?
Right.
Sun going down a little bit. Prophets out to the sun down. Do you got any more?
I got two more pieces.
You got anything? Bring them up.
I was just gonna say, Dr. Elaba Behrens, you know, because he came back here and he opened that gate, you know, to be here to this thing, and the trade gate, you know, we're doing. The scripture has to enter the straight gate, yo. And then he gets you out of walk, and that if he light, yo. There's one gate here, I will show you.
Yeah.
And if you enter into the straight gate, and the broad way is the left-hand side. And that is destruction, yo. The broad way is the left-hand side. And you cannot, beyond that is death. The one straight gate, I'm going to come back and you push that light, yo. And we here to preach that gospel, the straight gate. The scripture says that we don't lie, yo. You know, you're not going to get this in the church, because they're not going to talk that, because
they're
even telling you, even get tied, and he even, them sitting at BMW gospel, yo. And doctrine at BMW on the hall, and them praying for BMW, them praying for range, yo.
Lord!
Put your hand for range, and okay, that's true.
Exactly. God. Let me get them. First, second Maccabees 15. Second Maccabees 15.
Good burn, bro.
Yeah. That was a good burn, bro. Burn real smooth.
Yeah.
And it went out exactly as the sun going down.
Sure confidence that the Lord would help them. Like the Lord would help him. You see, it's like it.
Well, let's start at one. Let's start at one.
This is 2 Maccabees chapter 15, verse 1. But Ninaka. The book of Maccabees, 2 Maccabees chapter 15 verse 1. But Nicanor, hearing that Judas and his company were in the strong places, but Samaria resolved without any danger to set upon them on the Sabbath day. Verse 2. Nevertheless, the Jews that were compelled to go with him said, "Oh, destroy not so cruelly and barbarously, but give honor to that day, which he that seeth all things hath honored with holiness above other days." Three. Then the most egregious, wretched, demanded, like, yeah, those three. Then the most egregious, wretched, demanded that that had command the Sabbath day to be kept. Verse 14, like, yeah, verse 4. And when he said, "Here is in heaven a living Lord, and mighty, who commanded the seventh day to be kept. Five. Then said the other, and I also am mighty upon earth, and I commanded to take arms and to do the king's business. Yet he obtained not to have his wicked will done. So Nicanor, in descending pride and hardiness, determined to set up a public mountain for his victory over Judas and them that with Salakia, them that go with him. Salakia, seven. But Maccabeus had ever sure confidence that the Lord would help him.
That's right, that's the key. So you see what's going on in the history. I mean, what's going on with there, you see that Maccabeus, regardless of, you know, his adversaries and those that came up against him, you know, he had sure confidence in the Lord, right? And we have to follow after these footsteps,
right?
Follow after our, the elders and the priests, the leaders of our camp, before us, right? Because they show that endurance and that confidence and that faith. Okay?
With it, wherefore he exhorted his place not a fear to be to the coming of the heathen against them, but to remember the help which in former times they had received from heaven, and now to expect the victory and aid which should come upon them from the Almighty.
Yeah, so just like Abel Vivens, you know, was sent before the dreadful day, that dreadful day, brothers gotta be able to be exalted with telling you not to fear what Esau is gonna do during this time of Jacob's trouble.
Right.
That temptation, those tribulations, these are things that we must go through. Don't fear it, man. Alright?
Right.
Okay.
Khan, was nine. And so comforting them out of the law.
Out of what?
So comforting them out of the law.
No, buying them smoothies.
And so comforting them out of the law.
Yo, let's get rich. Let's get 401k. Let's get a pension. Let's store up our food, houses. How was the comforting coming from?
And comforting them out of the law.
Comforting them out of the law, the scriptures, right? Why? Because these are living words. They rest upon your soul. Right?
Yeah.
And the prophets, and
we comfort them out of the law and the prophets.
Right.
So we gotta speak highly of the prophets.
Yeah.
I don't know. You know what? Just read Second Mac, go to Maccabees real quick. Just jump straight to 7.
Read that. Second Maccabees 15, 7?
Second Maccabees 15 and 7, go straight to 7.
Second Maccabees 15 and 7. But Maccabeus had ever sure confidence that the Lord would help him with it. Wherefore he exhorted his people not to fear the coming of the heathen against them, but to remember the help which the former time they had received from heaven. And now,
you know what? Actually, we started reading this, that we started the video 4:30-ish. I think it has an hour in it, so it actually stopped 7 minutes ago. But yeah, read that. We're going to bring those last two pieces. So. Matter of fact, I'll read this, and then you bring out, because you want that as a precept to this. Again, Maccabees 15 to 7, but Maccabees had ever showed confidence that the Lord would help him. Verse 8, wherefore he exalted his people not to fear the coming of the heathen against them, but to remember the help which in former times they had received from heaven, and now to expect the victory and aid which should come unto them from the Almighty. Yes, and Maccabees is comforting the people,
which is what we're doing, comforting the people. Don't fear Jacob's trouble. Don't fear the mandates. Don't fear these things that Esau is going to do to you, right?
Verse 9. And so comforting them out of the law and the prophets, out of the law and the prophets, he's not telling them to get your 401k, he's not telling them invest in a pension, invest in stocks, he's not comforting them with prosperity doctrines, he's comforting them out of the law and the prophets, and without putting them to mind of the battles that day one of four, he made them more cheerful. So reminding them of what? The old past.
Right.
Of the battles that they faced. Now we're reminding you of the old past. Of the spiritual battles that we faced.
Right.
And them as well.
Right.
Right? Verse 10. And when he had stirred up the minds, he gave them their charge, showing them their without falsehood of the heathen and the breach of their oaths. Right? So he exposing the heathen. Verse 11. Thus he armed every one of them, not so much with defense and shields and spears,
so you didn't arm with defense, shields and spears,
as with comfortable and good words. Alright? Read that again. Thus he armed every one of them, not so much as defense of shields and spears, as with comfortable and good words, and besides, as that he told them the dream worthy to be believed, as if it had been so indeed, which did not a little rejoice in them, right? So he told them a dream, and you brothers could read down on to see the dream he was speaking on about him. You know what, let me jump to the point. I'm gonna read it. Verse 12. And this was his vision, that Onias, who had been the high priest, a virtuous and good man, reverend in conversation, gentle in condition, well-spoken also, exercised from a child, all points of virtue, holding up his hands, praying for the whole body of the Jews. This is what we do. Pray for the elect. Pray for the one-third, right? Verse 7, 13. This done in a matter where there appeared a man with gray hairs and exceedingly glorious, who was a wonderful and excellent majesty. Then Onias answered, saying, this is the love of thy brethren who pray much for the people in the home and for the holy city, to which Jeremiah the prophet. Wherefore Jeremiah, holding forth the right hand, gave Judas a sword of gold, and giving him this spake, take this holy sword, and give to the Most High, with and which thou shalt wound thy adversaries.
And how much more can you wound your adversaries with a holy sword than the scriptures?
Right.
Right. This is our holy sword. This is the golden sword that we're using to break down our adversaries, man.
Right.
Okay?
Bring on your chapter 15.
Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of the Most High, that ye may be able to withstand in the day of evil, in the evil day, and having done all to stand. Yeah, we just pretty much read that thing. The whole armor of the Lord, you know, this is what the Lord said, you know, and remember the good thing that the Lord did. You know, just comfort yourself. The scripture is the comforter. You're going to come back to the scripture, and I'm saying, this is what you're going to do. This is what you're going to do. Stand therefore, having your loins girded about truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness. Yes, you have to be righteous. Giving you step by step. How to fight the wicked, and what to use. You don't need no gun, you don't have to go to a gun in camp. You know, I don't know these people them, but I know they're really broke too, but they have a gun physically. I feel like that's a disrespect. They're like a violation to the Most High when the Lord, you know, the Lord telling what to use.
Exactly.
You should not go to the camp just to make sure, or just to make sure if somebody comes. So that means you really don't have no faith.
Exactly.
That means you're lying. You're not telling the truth about yourself.
Exactly.
Because if you had to bring a gun in camp, for some scarfer or somebody, so that means that you really want to kill.
Yeah.
You really want to kill.
Don't trust them.
you really want to, you make your mind to kill, because if you have a gun, you have to use it. You know, like trying to say, you wouldn't make nuclear weapon just to keep it rubbing down. You know what I mean? You bring a gun, you might use this gun. You know? When you skip just your pony, you hold on the road. You know? Continuing. And your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace.
Gospel
of peace, yo. Why you gospel? And your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. The theodoxy of peace. You know, because for the peace, you don't need to have a gun, no knife, no razor to cut them in your face. You only come and think of it. That's the doctrine, you know. The Lord didn't say that, you know. He didn't say bring these things, give us for the peace. 16. And above all, Father. 16. And above all, taking the shield of faith. Wherewith he shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked.
Now understand that statement. If it's quenching a dart, what does that mean? That means the dart hit.
Right.
Alright? The shield of faith is just that the dart is not going to burn you. It's not going to overthrow you. It's not going to turn you to ashes. But it will hit. Job was hit with boils and sores. Stephen was stoned to death. John the Baptist was put to death. The prophets was put to death.
Right.
So yes, you're gonna go through these hard times. Some of us are gonna be martyrs. It's true. But it said that the fiery darts is gonna be quenched by your faith. But you're not gonna burn forever.
Right.
The Lord's gonna make a way to escape.
Right. Ephesians 6 and 16. Above all, take the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. 17. And take the helmet of salvation.
Which means what? You're consistently thinking about salvation. There's nothing that's more priority than salvation. There's nothing that can come in your mind to block you from getting your crown. Your focus. You're going forward. You're going straight. Because you want that salvation.
Right?
That's what you're worried about. That's what you're focused on. That's your mindset.
And the word of the Spirit, which is the word of the Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shah.
Sword of the Spirit.
Right.
See?
Which and the sword, which is the Spirit, which is the word of the Most High.
That's right, which is the word of the Most High, the sword of the Spirit, that golden sword. That's what we take, and that's what we believe in, man.
Right.
Hey, man, that's it. Hey man, with that being said, we want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushan, Bashem, Rakah, Kadash. Double honors to the apostles, the great millstone for you well. Special salutations to the hope of your leg. Yahweh, Yahweh, the house of David, and to the confusion of faces scattered across the globe. Lord, Lord, this was edifying. You know, Lord, through the Holy Spirit, we can name this. You know, the truth never ends, the truth never gets out of course.
Right.
The truth is direct and straight. It doesn't change. Remain and abide in the truth.
Right.
Shalom.
Shalom to the priests and the elders and the shepherds for you. Shalom.
Oh.